Judy. No one's awake. There's not a light anywhere.
Greta, is there any chance of getting something to eat? I'm starving.
Oh, I am too. I hope no one's closed this window. I fixed it open. Oh, good. It's all right. I'll climb through and open the door for you. Oh, my flowers, please. We'll have to creep upstairs, otherwise we'll wake Aunt Liesl. My feet ache.
Are you very tired?
Yes, but it was worth it. I've never been close to mountains at night before. I thought they'd be frightening.
I'm so hungry, I can't think of anything.
I'll see if there's some bread and cheese in the kitchen. Oh, dear. We'll have to wait until Hattie gets up. I've got more moon blossoms than you. Aren't they lovely? Did you wish on each one?
Yes, I wished on each one.
What did you wish?
Well, first I wished to be left in peace by that horrible aunt of yours. How can I work if all the time she's screaming at me about money? So then I wished for enough money to pay the rent so that she'd leave me alone and shut up.
Well, that only used up one blossom. What did you wish for the other?
I wished a very exciting wish. I wished that I should conduct a whole operetta written by myself at the Theatre Under Wien.
And then?
It would run for 2 years.
They're very exciting wishes.
Oh, Greta. I sometimes wonder whether anyone besides you will ever listen to my music.
Oh, Rudy. One day, the whole world will listen to your music.
Ooh. And your wishes? Were they exciting too?
Only to me.
Tell me.
No.
Go on.
All right then. Only I used up all my blossoms on one wish, to make it certain. I wished that I would grow up quickly.
Why? Don't you like being 15?
Well, I would if you were 15.
I'm not.
I know, and by the time I'm ready for you, you'll be past it.
Oh, thank you.
Well, you'll have found someone else.
Well, I haven't yet. Except, of course, her.
Her?
Yes, her. You must have met her, haven't you?
What's she like?
Oh, she's very polished.
She would be.
And she has flashing white teeth.
Do you love her very much?
I adore her. She's all I've got. What's the matter?
Go away.
Why are you crying?
I'm not crying. What's it got to do with you anyway? You've got your beastly polished lady with her white teeth.
But she isn't a lady.
Oh, that's worse. I'm so miserable.
Greta, Greta, you must know who I meant. Fräulein Keyes.
I don't care what her name is.
Fräulein Keyes. My piano.
Your piano? Oh, Rudy. Of course. She's polished and has white teeth.
My piano!
What's the matter?
Greta! My piano's gone!
You're awake, Aunt Liesl!
Well, I must get in. I'll go round to the front door.
Oh, Rudy! Rudy! You'll find it. They've just moved it somewhere.
My piano! She's done this to me. And it might have rained.
She said she would. Hattie heard her.
If I didn't take her seriously, I mean, what's 6 months' rent compared with my piano? And it might have rent.
Oh, Rudy, you're not going to pay us.
Well, of course I am. I must see if she's all right.
You'll wake everyone up.
I don't care if I wake up everyone in the whole world.
Is she all right?
Yes. Well, perhaps she likes staying out all night.
Thank you.
told Ramona it was Aunt Liesel.
What's he about like bad things at 5 in the morning? You'll wake your aunt.
Don't care if I do wake her, the wicked old witch. It's all right, Hattie. I said witch. How could you let her do this to me?
I tried to stop her. I said one drop of rain and his career's gone.
Is this filthy hole the only guest house in Austria?
No. It's the only one you can stay for 6 months for nothing.
She'll have her money, even if I had to sell everything I owe.
Well, that won't fetch you in very much.
Oh, Hattie, we're so hungry.
And hungry you'll be.
Not if you were to give us some breakfast.
Nice bit of crisp bacon. And a couple of fried eggs.
Oh, lovely.
Yes, I dare say it is, but not for you. Oh, I've got breakfast for 18 to get for 6 o'clock. Oh, just look at all these tables and chairs, all higgledy-piggledy.
Oh, we'll help.
So I should hope.
If you'll give us some breakfast.
I'll do no such thing.
Oh, Hattie, darling Hattie, we're so hungry.
Hungry all day.
Who's coming?
Some officers and their actress friends. They spend all night drinking, and then they come here to get rid of the fumes. Oh, stop playing waves. Greta, you go and get the knives and forks there in the big drawer.
I never work in this house.
I suppose you know you've been turned out.
I've been turned out before.
This time she means it. She's locked the door of your room.
She can't do that.
Well, she has.
I must say, it's the first time she's put my piano out.
She's done worse than that. She's sold it.
She's what?
She's sold it to Schollmeyer. And he's coming at 9 o'clock to take it away.
She's sold my piano? I'll put her in prison.
Well, there'll be two of you there.
Hattie, how much did that vile woman get for it?
1,000 kronas.
It's worth 10!
And Schollmeyer's coming at 9 to take it away.
Hattie, what do I owe for my room?
1,000 kronas.
1,000 kronas. And Schollmeyer's coming at 9. I'll get it. I'll get it before then.
You'll have to look slippy.
Don't I know it? I'll have to sell everything I've got and a few things you've got, too.
Rudy, what's the matter? You'll wake her.
Hattie says she sold my piano.
She's what?
And she's locked the door of my room.
That's all right. I've got the key.
Oh, Greta, you're an angel, and I love you.
Well, say that again.
What? Oh, you're an angel. And I love you.
Because I got the key.
No. No other things to... Come on. Now, you stand guard outside while I sort out my things. And if you hear anyone coming, let me know, and I'll lock the door from the inside.
All right. She's sure to wake up when the breakfast party comes.
We've got a uniform for every duty we fulfill. Ladies still from a drill get the thrill. And when they ask us why we choose a soldier's life, we say it is to find ourselves a lovely wife. And so we always wear our uniform with buttons bright. Such a sight to delight you tonight. And when they ask us why we choose a soldier's life, we say it is to find ourselves a lovely wife.
We'd like you to wait.
Ransel, where have you been?
Playing the cab so he'll wait for us.
Did he rob you?
Rob me? Well, I think I bought the horses too, yes.
Well, what about breakfast, Ransel? Well, you said there'd be breakfast.
So there will be, my little pig. I spoke to Hattie herself.
Oh, and who might Hattie be?
The best cook in the world.
Well, where is she?
Just give me a minute, I'll go and find her.
If she's still in bed, we'll go and pull her out.
We'll pull Hattie out of bed.
Oh, you will you?
Oh,
Bigger boys than you have tried to pull me out of bed and into it.
And did they succeed, Hattie?
That's neither here nor there.
You're a wicked old woman, Hattie, but I worship you.
Put me down! Oh, let me alone! Oh, you wicked boys.
All right, now we're going.
Or you won't get your bacon and eggs.
Where's the food, Franzel?
It's going to be bacon and eggs.
English food. I adore English food.
Oh, dear. Oh, what a pity Maria didn't come. Breakfast here was her idea.
Yes, but I think a breakfast is a bad idea. You can't have music with breakfast.
I don't see why not.
Good morning, Fräulein. Do you have a private orchestra?
No, but I have the best pianist in the world. He's terribly expensive.
How expensive?
Well, he'd want at least 20 kronen.
I think we should be able to manage 20 kronen between us.
Of course, he may want more. I'll go and ask him.
Pretty child.
And a businesswoman.
Franzel.
Good Lord, a grand piano. Business must be looking up.
Will you kindly stop annoying my piano?
Your piano?
Certainly.
Oh, so you're the best pianist in the world.
And a composer, too.
What's your name?
Rudy Kleber.
What do you compose? Great symphonies, fugues, operas?
No, just waltzes.
Oh, just waltzes. What a relief. Perhaps you might hear one.
Well, I should love to play for you. The only trouble is I only play professionally.
Professionally, and what would that mean?
That would mean that I would like a fee.
In advance?
Certainly.
But why should we pay for something we don't know about?
Well, you get paid from the moment that you join the army. The people who pay you don't know for certain whether you can fight or not.
Well, I suppose they take us on trust.
Then you'll have to take me on trust.
Well, I don't see why not. How much do you want?
30 kronen.
The little girl said 20.
Oh, no, 30. I assure you, 20 is for one hand only.
You're quite mistaken, she said. Thank you, Herr
Kleber. And what is your name?
Franzel von Filmetz.
Oh, an aristocrat. How do you do?
How do you do?
And now I will play for you my latest waltz. You may follow it in the manuscripts if you wish. I write them out myself. Some do, and some don't. I do because I can. Don't let me interrupt the conversation. I shall, in any case, only be playing to please myself.
Quiet, everybody. He wants to play.
Oh, there's no extra charge for listening.
Oh, hadn't thought of that.
Waltz of my heart.
The lark is singing on high, the sun's a shining the blue, the winter is driven away, and spring is returning.
It's a charming tune.
Yeah. Would you like to buy it?
To buy it? Is it for sale?
Yes. They're all for sale. I have several more. I just throw them off. I have a few debts to pay.
I thought
perhaps you would like to buy it. You might be glad one day when I'm famous.
Well, I would like a waltz of my own.
Of course.
Well, steady on. You'll rob us.
No, I won't rob you. You just pay me what you think it's worth.
What about 50 kronen? No, I'd give more than that. I'd give 75.
80. 90. That's a good idea. You all bid against each other and the highest bid gets it.
I'd give you 100 kronen and not one more.
110. 125.
Please, I really would love a waltz of my own.
Very well then, 150 kronen.
150. I'll tell you what. I'll play it once more. And then you'll like it more, and I shall get more.
I think 150 is ample.
Not when you hear it again. This time I'll play it with expression. I usually charge more for expression.
Oh.
Cronin. Well, are you all struck dumb by my offer? Isn't anyone going to outbid me?
Maria, we've given you up.
Maria, just in time to take this.
Well, what do you say?
If you offer me a 1,000 kronen for it? It must be a very good waltz.
I don't know about that. But it happens to be just the tune I'm looking for my new operetta. We're rehearsing it now.
A new operetta? Who's written the music?
Otto Breitkopf.
You have my deepest sympathy.
You have very definite opinions. What is your name?
Rudy Kleber.
I'm Maria Ziegler.
Maria Ziegler?
Doubtless you've seen me act.
No, no, unfortunately, I've never seen you act. I'm too poor to afford theatre tickets.
But you know who I am.
Oh, yes, yes, I know who you are. Everybody in Vienna knows who you are. I've seen your photographs in all the magazines. You're not so pretty as your photographs, but you're very much nicer. I shouldn't like to meet your photographs, but I very much like meeting you.
Are you always as candid as this?
Always. It saves time.
And yet you hope to succeed?
I don't hope. I know. And now, please, could I have my 1,000 kronen?
You don't trust me?
It's important, you see, that I have the money by 9 o'clock, otherwise they'll try and take away my piano.
Your piano? Why?
Well, I owe the old lady who owns the place 6 months' rent, and I fear she's beginning to lose confidence.
Then tell her I will be responsible.
No, that wouldn't be right. I will pay for it, with my waltz.
You mean with my money?
It's the same thing.
Franzl, have you got 1,000 kronen?
No, not on me. You've got a check.
No, thank you, really. I had a check once. I've still got it.
Then we shall have to make a collection. No, we shan't need your 200. You can pay for the breakfast. And here, Herr Kleber, are your 1,000 kronen.
And here is your waltz.
No, your waltz. That 1,000 kronen only gives me the exclusive right to sing it. Then it will be published, and you will make lots and lots of money.
I have several more here. Well, there's enough in the basket for a whole operetta.
Perhaps my next. Vienna needs a new composer.
Yes, me.
Oh, what terrible conceit. No, it's not conceit, it's knowledge. I'm like that too. No one can tell me when I sing well or badly. I know. Well, why are you looking so worried?
Well, you see, it's very important that I get a message to Schollmeier, but... Greta! This is my little friend, Greta Schoen. Greta, do you know who that is? It's Maria Ziegler. Greta. Run to Schollmeier. Give him the message. Tell him that your Aunt Liesel has changed her mind and she is not going to sell the piano. I can now pay her the rent I owe.
But Maria Ziegler gave you the money.
No. Nobody gave me the money. I earned it with my music.
Oh, that's all right, then. I'll get Schollmeier before he starts out. Oh, Rudy, your wish. It started.
What a charming girl. Is she a relation?
No, she's just a friend. She wants to marry me. She will one day if I'm not careful.
Breakfast!
Maria, breakfast.
Well, there's no room for me. There should be. This was my idea.
Maria, please, have my chair.
We thought you'd forgotten. How did you get here?
By the dawn boat. Hey, Kleber, won't you join us?
No, thank you. The sight of all that money has quite taken my appetite away. I'll pay for you while you eat.
Go on.
guess you sing for us.
No.
Yes, too early in the morning.
Oh, not for you. Oh, please.
All right, then. Charles, you're so argumentative.
I'm not argumentative, but I should like to know your real reason for bringing me out here.
I told you. I think I found a genius, and I want your influence with the directors of the theater under Wien. This man has talent.
Yes, and looks.
I hadn't noticed.
Maria, what are you up to?
A great deal.
Oh, you can tell me. I shan't be hurt. I gave up being that a long time ago.
When?
The first time I found you out. Oh.
But he was an Italian. One must have an Italian once. It's like having the measles. And besides, I was furious with you. I said I'd marry you, and you looked right through me. An unknown chorus girl to the noble house of Metterling. I know now it would be very smart to be married to Maria Ziegler, but then...
Maria. Will you marry me? Now. Today.
Is this a serious proposition?
Naturally.
Why so suddenly? You've never asked me before.
Because I have a strong feeling I'm going to lose you. I mean it, Maria, will you?
No, Charles. We know too much about each other. When I marry, if I marry, it must be to someone new and exciting.
And this genius? Are you thinking of marrying him?
Fräulein Ziegler, I've packed all my things. Where shall I tell them to send my piano?
Maria Metterling, Weberstrasse 10.
Maria?
Isn't it charming of Prince Metterling? A large studio at the top of his house, doing nothing. It'll be ideal. We don't know how to thank you. Herr Kleber, are you going to see the directors of the theatre in that costume?
Oh, no, no, I have my best trousers, complete with legs down to the floor in here.
Well, why don't you put them in the cab?
Yes.
Really, Maria, I can stand most things, but this fellow living in my house...
You won't have to see him except at meals. Don't look so worried. I'll soon take him off your hands.
You know, Maria, you can be very aggravating sometimes. It makes me... uneasy.
Leave you like that. Oh. Carriage is at the door.
It'll be back soon.
Come on, dry your eyes.
Greta?
Oh, Rudy. You've come back. You didn't forget.
Forget?
I thought I wasn't going to see you again. I wanted to die. Oh, Rudy, you're all I've got. You will wait for me, won't you?
Dear child. Don't you realize you're all I've got?
Child, there you are, you see. That's all I am to you. But I shan't always be. Promise.
What?
Promise you'll never ask her or anyone to marry you until you've seen if I'm good enough.
Good enough?
I may grow up awful, and if I do, you can say you're awful now. You used not to be. But give me a chance. No, don't laugh. I really mean this. Promise.
I promise.
Not with a smile. Look at me and say it.
I promise never to ask anyone to marry me.
Until I've given you. Go on.
Until I've given you.
The first refusal.
The first refusal.
And you'll never tell a soul in the world?
Not if you don't want me to now. Must go now.
Yes.
I'll be back.
When?
Soon.
Go on. You mustn't keep him waiting.
No. I'd like to. You've kept me waiting for years.
A little brighter tone.
muscles.
Your voice isn't tired at all. Maria, you have no discipline. When I had to sing a new part, I went to bed for a week.
With?
That's beside the point. Maria, you're very wicked.
Well, so are you when you were my age.
Who is it?
No one.
Don't lie to me. Who is it?
Oh, it's ridiculous. A nobody. A composer.
A composer? Fatal.
That's just what it is, Fatal. I put him in a lovely studio and he treats me like a bank manager. How dare he be late?
Maria, in all the years you've studied with me, I've never known you like this. Your first night is in 2 weeks' time. You must control yourself until then.
But how can I sing his music if I know he hates me? No, I'm wrong. He doesn't hate me. He doesn't even know I'm there. You must believe me. For the first time, I am in love. No, don't laugh. It's real. For the first time, I want to marry, to have a home, children. I would even give up the stage. Oh, that must be him. Oh, it's you, Charles.
Obviously.
Well, you can't stay. We're in the middle of our lesson.
Your lesson, of course. Frau Kurt, forgive me for interrupting.
Interrupting? Maria's impossible. I can't get her to sing a note.
Yes, my nerves are terrible.
You should relax more, my dear. Take it easy. A little diversion. I was going to suggest supper tonight. A little dancing, perhaps.
No, I can't tonight.
Well, then, tomorrow.
No, I've promised Breitkopf.
Breitkopf? Are you still on speaking terms with him since you threw out his latest song?
That man wrote his last song 20 years ago. He's a has-been.
Never mind. We've several young composers coming along quite nicely.
Ooh.
Well, there's Rudolf Kleber and Rudy Kleber and Rudy and Kleber and Kleber.
Charles,
and
you have a very sweet nature. Sarcasm doesn't suit you.
Sarcasm, not at all. Only I was wondering what had happened to the days when you were free for supper every evening, rehearsals or no.
That was before I took my work seriously.
Or before you took yourself seriously? I shouldn't.
Charles, do go now. You're interrupting our work.
Ah, work, work, and more work.
Hello, Charles.
At last! How dare you keep Frau Kurt waiting?
I'm sorry I'm late.
Rudy, this is my beloved teacher, Frau Kurt. And now, Charles, you must go. We really must get to work.
I had hoped you would allow me to stay.
No, you're too distracting.
Very well. Goodbye, my dear. And don't work too hard. Emotionally.
You must forgive me, I'm not very happy today. My little friend Greta has gone away to school in England.
Poor child. Was she unhappy?
Yes, she was for a time after her aunt died. But not now. I've managed to send Hattie with her until she gets settled.
Oh, so you've sent a chaperone all the way to England with her. My, you must have suddenly become rich.
Well, now, if you two have quite finished talking, I have been here for over an hour.
A thousand apologies. Rudy, do you realize that this is Frau Kassilla-Kurt?
Frau Kurt, do you know my father once walked all the way from Innsbruck to hear you sing Isolde?
Ah, I was a soprano then. But later I became a contralto. It's not much fun singing contralto. In a few years, I shall be basso profundo.
Good heavens, what a wind.
Well, now, I have been here for over an hour and we've done no work.
Well, what shall we do first? Shall we do the duet with the mother, the lullaby? What's it called?
The Wings of Sleep.
Is that one of his?
Yes. He played it for us so much at rehearsals that in desperation we had to put it in.
Nothing of the kind. You've put it in because it was better than the one you had.
Do you have a copy?
Yes.
Will you sing it with me?
I'll try.
This is meant to be a duet, you know, not a trance.
Forgetting, slowly said.
end of Act One. Where is he?
Maria, there is no love duet at the end of Act One. We finish on the full chorus number, as in the score.
I've changed that.
Since when?
Since Rudy Kleber played it to me last night.
But this changes everything. None of my music will be left.
Exactly, Herr Otto Breitkopf. You are musically written out. And if you listen to this duet, you will understand why. Now, where is Rudy? Ah, oh, there you are. I want to rehearse with Cheruti, My Life Belongs to You. Can we have the parts, please?
Maria, it's still in a very rough state. I've got to work it.
Well, we'll go through it now, and then you can work on it. I want Cheruti to hear it. Will you accompany us?
Yes, very well. Don't you absolutely adore it?
Yes, it's enchanting.
What about Maria?
Oh, delicious.
I keep humming that tune.
Yes, we've heard it.
I've come across the loveliest piece of gossip. Can you keep a secret?
I never can.
I've heard that Maria and Charles have finished.
But they can't have.
They're never seen together. They used to ride every morning. Lunch at the Koblenz, have tea together, supper at Locker's, and now not a sign of them.
Well, I expect Maria's been busy rehearsing.
Yes. And that's my other piece of gossip. What's the composer's name? Rudy something or other?
Rudy Kleber.
Well, they do say that he's the reason.
Oh, Rudy. Well, I'm sure it's impossible. I was there at the inn when they met. At 6 in the morning, he played the piano.
That doesn't make him unattractive.
Well, I'm quite sure you're wrong.
Charles told a friend of mine.
Yes, Lottie. And what did Charles tell?
Hello, Charles.
You're looking charming, Lottie.
Charles, do back me up. Now, didn't I discover our newest composer? Countess Lottie won't believe me.
Oh, but he did. With several other drunken rowdies at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Yes, he played the piano and Maria...
Yes, Fransel. Maria, you were going to say.
Well, Maria turned up and bought a waltz of his.
So that's when he fell in love with her.
Did he? How interesting. Maria never told me that.
Of course, it's only hearsay.
Ah, yes, but it might be true. I must ask her tonight.
Then you are seeing her tonight?
But of course, Maria always has supper with me after her first night.
But I thought...
Oh, I shouldn't if I were you, Lottie. You're much too pretty to take.
I don't quite know how to take that. But I'm relieved you're seeing each other. I'm fond of you both. People are so unkind. I wouldn't like anything to go wrong.
Well, if it does, Lottie, I'm sure you'll be the first to know.
Charles, you're being a beast. I shall retire to my box and keep my opera glasses glued to the conductor. It is the composer conducting. Come along, Fransel.
Fransel?
Yes.
If you hear any more rumors about Maria and Kleber, you might deny them.
Of course, I knew it was impossible.
Of course. Quite impossible. Oh, Fransel, there's something else. I'd like you to do me a favor. I may have to go away for a while. If I do, you might keep an eye on our protege.
On Rudy?
Yes. He's new to Vienna and rather vulnerable. Doesn't quite know his way around. He might get hurt. I shouldn't like that to happen.
Well, of course, I'll keep an eye on him.
Thank you, Fransel.
Your Highness, the Fräulein Ziegler says, would you excuse her tonight? She's very tired and she's sure you'll understand.
Understand? Did she say anything else?
She was just going on the stage, but I think she said she was sorry.
Thank you. Sorry.
Frank, but no.
champagne's getting flat.
I like it flat.
Maria?
Yes.
I'm so drunk.
Well, who wouldn't be?
Well, I like it. Maria!
Yes.
What are you doing in there?
Comfortable.
I wish I was.
Well, I'll bring you a dressing gown.
A dressing gown? Oh, that sounds nice. This jacket I borrowed is so tight and uncomfortable.
Well, take it off.
Yes, take it off. La-da-da-dee-da-da-dee-da-da. Oh, what a relief.
Put this on and relax.
Oh, that's nice. Velvet and silk. Oh, I've never worn anything velvet and silk before. Oh, look. It's a man's dressing gown. Why do you wear a man's dressing gown?
Oh, they're better cut. It amuses me.
Oh. Oh, I shall get one like this.
Yes, and why not? And silk shirts and ties. You're going to be so rich.
Am I? Oh, I'm so glad. Maria, you wouldn't like to let me have this one cheap. Oh, I'm so drunk.
Well, if you can't be drunk after tonight, when can you?
Oh, but I was drunk all the way through the performance.
Rudy.
Oh, not with wine, with excitement and power. Having that big orchestra down there to do anything I wanted. I felt like a king. Oh, by the way, you missed four bars in the finale.
I did nothing of the sort.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. And do you know why? Instead of looking at my baton, you were looking at me. And that's wrong, you know. That's wrong. You shouldn't mix business with pleasure.
Pleasure? I like
that.
Well,
wasn't it? I could see you up there on that stage looking down at me. Hmm? I found that. I boosted it. I created it. Clever Maria.
Yes, clever Maria.
Yes, clever Maria. Well, I'm going to tell you something, clever Maria, because I'm very drunk and my tongue is very loose. You know how grateful I am to you hearing my music played and sung like that for the first time. It was as near to heaven as I shall ever be, but I would have you know that I am not just another new composer to be exploited at your will. I'm me. I'm Rudy Claver.
You should know by now that I agree with you.
Maria, will you be honest with me? Are you in love with me? And when I say love, I mean love, not something quick and furtive that means nothing, because if it's that, then we might just as well say goodbye now.
Goodbye?
Yes. Something strange and beautiful has happened, and I don't know if I can explain it. You and my music have become one. And I love and respect my music, therefore I must learn to love and respect you. And love and respect are enduring things.
But that's what I want. Enduring things.
You do.
That's why I knew the moment I saw you that it was important. Something I've been waiting for, someone I could help and put before myself. I'm appallingly selfish,
no.
But not with you. With you, I only want to give.
When I was young, my foolish fancies used to make a great mistake. But now a little love, living has changed my ways and taught me and brought me the joy of giving.
go away, won't we? We'll see all the loveliest places, and this time I shall see them through your eyes.
This time. Maria, you know there's something that's been worrying me, hurting me right from the start.
I know. Charles.
Yes, Charles. I'd like to know.
There is nothing to know now.
There's not.
No, I told you. That was over long before I met you.
People still talk.
Well, that's because we're still friends.
Still friends. Yes. Yes, of course, that must be it. Still friends. People are so unkind. I'd like Charles for a friend. He's good. And he's kind. I wouldn't like him to be hurt through me.
He won't be. I'm sure it's over for him as much as it is for me.
I'm sorry to startle you, but I suddenly realized half my things are here. Hello, Rudy. How do you feel after your great triumph tonight? What are you doing in my dressing gown? May I have it, please? I shall want it on the train.
Your dressing gown? Charles, I'm sorry. I didn't know it was your dressing gown.
Whose else could it be?
This is a trick. He's done this deliberately.
Has he?
Good heavens, man, what are you doing in that awful made-up tie? You'd best take one of mine. There are some in the drawer opposite the dressing table. I know there are some there. I saw them there last night.
You were here last night?
But of course.
Yes, but you didn't tell him why you were here last night, to say goodbye.
Yes, a fond farewell, but only for a few weeks, I hope. Unless I find London a lot more exciting than I think it is. Well, Rudy, you must be delighted with your success tonight. Lorelei will play the whole season. My congratulations.
Thank you. Charles, I won't be coming to your studio again. You've been most kind to let me have it for so long.
Have I offended you in any way?
Offended me? In no way at all. It has been a great education to know you. Both of you.
Rudy?
He won't come back.
I know. Why have you done this to me? How could you?
Maria, listen to me. Isn't it better he should be hurt a little now than break his heart later?
But why should he be hurt? Why should his heart be broken ever? Not by me.
Has anyone ever lasted with you?
Of course no one has lasted with me, because until now no one has meant anything. Have I ever pretended with you or anyone? And now, just when I'd found... Oh, go away. Can't you see that this was real? Come back.
Yes.
I didn't think you would.
I didn't at first, but then I realized you must be just as unhappy as I was, so I came back.
To tell me I'm a liar and a cheat?
No. If you are those things, you must know that for yourself. I came back because I heard you say to Charles in there that this was real.
And how do you know that wasn't a lie, too?
It's because I'm a musician and I can hear when a note is false. There was no false note in your voice.
Rudy, I'm going to say this to you now, once, and then never again. But he's meant nothing to me since I met you.
He came here last night to ask me to marry him or to say goodbye. We said goodbye. That's the absolute truth. Do you believe me?
Yes. Close times. When women cry, their eyes get dull and swarm with tears. Yours are larger than ever. Very soft and very sweet.
And you won't ever believe...
I shall never think of anything but this very moment. Yesterday is unimportant because it is yesterday. Never try to arrange a gala. It's torture.
This place is bedlam. Nothing but singers and dancers.
By the way, have you seen Franz?
Dr. Fitzgreta?
Oh, yes, of course, I've forgotten. I can still hardly believe it. Our little Greta. Coming home today. Tell me, Hattie, tell me. Can she really dance? Well, it's the new waltz, you see. They'll expect it. Can she do it?
Of course she can. She's danced before the King and Queen of England. And what's good enough for them?
They picked her out, too.
Our little Greta. Our little Greta. And all of that in 3 years?
A lot's happened in 3 years.
A great deal has happened. My music being played and sung all over the world. And to think it all started that morning in the garden. Maria. That lark's voice at 6 in the morning. It's all her, this, you know.
Why don't you two get married?
What?
You heard what I said. You haven't asked her, have you? Why, if I'm not, she'd like it.
Hattie, I've never told this to anyone before because I'm superstitious. Made a vow.
Vow? Who told you?
To a child. To stop her heart from breaking. The heart of a child is a brittle thing. Hello. What have you been?
Out on the lake, studying. Hattie, bring me some delicious iced tea, please.
Not until you've cooled down a bit. You won't get a stroke, do you? I'll bring it in 10 minutes.
Have you been asleep?
No, I'm trying to do some work.
You're happy today, aren't you? Your little Greta's coming home. You've been good to that child. How old is she now? 15, 16?
No, she's older than that now.
We must look around for a nice young husband for her.
A husband for Greta? Oh, I don't think that's a good idea.
Why not?
I just don't think it's a very good idea.
Well, I do. After all, there must be some young sprigs of nobility growing up. Oh, I forgot. I don't meet the nobility. I'm not allowed to. They consider my position a little dubious, which of course it is. I can sing to them at charity, and they applaud heartily, but when you are invited to tea, I'm not. It's curious, isn't it?
Do you want to go to tea?
No.
What are you making such a fuss about?
Well, can you imagine me sitting there bolt upright and eating horrid little cakes and wishing I were dead? And to think I might have been one of them, me.
Yes. Princess, you.
Yes. Princess, me.
By the way, do you ever hear from him?
Him who?
Charles met him.
Funnily enough, I heard from him this morning. He's at Waldsee now. He might be coming over.
Oh, might he? Oh, that's very interesting. Yes. Yes, he might be coming over when I invite him.
When I invite him? I do believe you're jealous.
Yes, of course I'm jealous.
I worship you. I adore you. Jealous still?
Yes. And I will still be jealous. We're very, very old, with thousands of grandchildren coming all over us.
That's far too old.
All right, then. Not grand, just children.
Aren't you anticipating, rather?
What?
Children?
Well, not real ones, just imaginary ones.
You have the most charming way of saying the most hurtful things.
Hurtful? I'm sorry.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. I'm sorry.
All right. And now shall we do some work? I don't know the last page of that gavotte. Have you got it there?
No. But I have something else I'd like you to try.
What is it?
Oh, it's just something I read last night.
A new waltz?
No. No, it's not a waltz. It's, yes. It's a simple little tune. See if you like it.
It's dedicated to me.
They're all dedicated to you. This one is especially.
Your writing is terrible. I can't read it. You read it for me. I don't want to spoil it.
My dearest dear.
I'll try not to question again. There is something I don't understand. Perhaps we're not meant to. I'm content with being just as we are. Are you content?
Content? Don't you realize by now? You're the other half of me.
Hello?
We were just
practicing.
Yes.
I know, I shouldn't have come in this way at all.
Actually, it isn't the front entrance,
Rudy.
But... Greta? It's darling Greta. Maria. It's little Greta.
Not so little.
You're Maria Ziegler, aren't you? I remember you.
And you're the little girl who crawled from under the piano.
Well, I can't think what to say. I'm so ashamed. I didn't recognize you.
No, you didn't.
But what's happened? You've grown quite lovely. She's lovely, isn't she, Maria?
Yes. I expect it's the clothes. I'm still the same.
Oh, Rudy, how thoughtless we are. After that long journey, you must be longing for a bath.
Oh, thank you, no. I can't wait to see Hattie.
Yes, of course, Hattie. Hattie. Oh, yeah, Hattie. Simply. Hattie! Hattie! Who do you think's arrived?
She's been divine to me. She's written to me every week.
I hope Rudy has too.
Oh, yes. But not all the time. How could he?
I can't tell you how excited he's been about your coming. He's talked of nothing else.
Hattie, where is she?
There.
Oh, Hattie. There she is.
Oh, let's have a look at you. Oh, my, what a big girl you've got. Isn't she lovely? Hattie, take her upstairs to her room. She must be exhausted.
Oh, no, not in that pokey room.
I want to see her here.
In the sunlight.
Oh, Hattie.
Did you have a good journey?
Yeah, men try to bother you.
Oh, well,
you know what men are like on railway carriages.
Oh, darling.
I'll see how things are put in her room.
Thank you, Maria. We've been so excited about your coming.
Oh, Rudy, don't forget the rehearsal.
No, I won't. Greta.
Rudy. Oh. I can't see to the rest of her luggage.
I was trying to think why it was that I didn't recognize you. And now I know. It's the hair. It goes up instead of down.
Oh, Rudy, thank you for sending Franzl to meet me.
He's my best friend.
I recognized him from all those years ago.
I'd have come myself.
I know, the gala.
Oh, I've written a new waltz, which you are going to dance.
Is it a lovely tune?
Oh, I think so. But then again, I would, wouldn't I?
I can't wait to hear it.
Oh, there you are. Shout us as soon
as it's in your room. Where did you get to? We got out of the car. I bent down to get the baggage out and found myself left.
Yes, I wanted to get in quick.
Yes, everything's gone wrong today. You see, I started the day badly. I saw Hattie through glass.
Oh, most amusing. Come along, dear, up to your room. Change out of those dusty clothes.
All right.
Now, don't you stay there too long. Just because we've arrived, I'm not going to be ignored. How long?
10 minutes?
No, much too long.
20 minutes?
Eternity.
All right, then, 5.
Heaven. You shouldn't do these things to me, you know? I got to meet some schoolgirl from England, and out of the train pops that.
Yes. Oh, she's lovely, isn't she?
Oh, yes.
Tell me, Franz, did she talk about me in the car?
It's never stopped. Do you think Rudy would? Did you know that Rudy had? Have you heard that Rudy will?
Yes, she was always like that. Oh, Franzl. Have you ever seen a completely happy man? Because you're looking at one right now.
But you haven't fallen in love with her too, have you?
In love with... Oh, no, no, no. I love my little Greta, always have. Always will. But how can I be in love twice?
Thank goodness for that. Do you notice the way she moves? I bet she dances divinely.
Yes.
I'm sorry to interrupt this rhapsody, but Greta's having trouble with her trunk. It's stuck.
It's stuck.
It's stuck.
I'll fix it. I'll open it. I am marvelous with trunks. Which is her room?
Third on the left.
Thanks. Rudy, you won't be wanting me for a minute, will you?
I don't think I should be wanting you ever again.
Good, because that trunk may take a long time to fix. Oh, Maria. Have you ever been in love?
Am I right in thinking that there's a romance in the air?
Romance? Well, there's two kids. Oh, don't be so silly.
Well, I don't think there's anything very silly about it. After all, how old is Francois?
24, 25.
Well, then that's perfect. And Francois will be quite rich. It'll be ideal. Well,
why are you so anxious to dispose of her so soon?
Well, I'm not, but I don't want her position to be dubious, too. After all, what is she to you, your ward?
No, not exactly, but I feel responsible for her. Since her aunt died, she has no one else.
Well, that won't be for long. She's lovely. It'll be ideal. A nice young marriage. That's what we want. Or perhaps you were thinking of planning a career for her.
I might do worse.
I'm told she dances charmingly. Or why don't you write an operetta where the heroine doesn't sing a note? I'm told this happens often in England.
Well, perhaps she sings charmingly too.
Well, she doesn't.
How do you know?
First thing I ask. Well, why are you laughing?
I'm laughing at you. With everything in the world and yet so very, very unsure of yourself.
Yes, I'm unsure. And who's made me unsure? I don't like things and people that were in your life before me. They make me feel shut out. And when I feel shut out, I do unaccountable things.
Well, don't do them here because I'm being driven nearly mad by this gala.
Still? Over.
Yes, still.
What? With a new and relishing prima donna to add to your illustrious list of guests. Why don't you let her sing my part or perhaps even dance it? I've often felt that grand opera needed dancing.
Maria, you are impossible.
Yes, I am impossible. The whole thing's impossible. Everything's impossible.
I can't stand this. I'm going.
And what about the rehearsal?
Oh, damn the rehearsal. Damn everything.
Otto!
Yes, Fräulein.
Otto. I want you to catch the first boat to Waldsee and deliver this personally to Prince Charles Metterling.
Yes, Fräulein.
If you hurry, you'll just catch the next boat. Go on, hurry! Quite all right.
That's quite all right. Come on, Maria. Don't speak to me with icicles in your voice.
Well, I'm not, but I'm all on edge.
Of course you are. The whole house is on edge. It's this gala. But we mustn't let it affect us.
No.
No.
We mustn't. Oh, my God. Otto. Otto! Otto, come back!
Where's he gone?
To Pertisau. I thought I wanted something, but I really don't need it now.
What was it you thought you needed?
Writing paper.
Writing paper? Mm. With plenty of writing paper.
Yes. With plenty. Rudy, don't you think it would be nice if we invited Charles over?
Charles? Oh, Charles Metterling. Yes, he's at Waldsee now, isn't he? Do you want to ask him over?
No, not really, but... Well, I thought it might be sort of polite.
Yes. It might be sort of polite. Why don't you ask him?
You don't mind?
No.
Oh, then I'll send him a note now. Now, isn't that silly? If I'd only known, I could have sent Otto with it.
Mm. What time are you expecting him?
Did you manage the trunk?
With one flick of the wrist.
I adore my room. And the moon blossoms. Hattie's remembered how much I like them.
Franco, these two haven't seen each other for 3 years. They have a lot to talk about.
Oh, yes, of course.
Take me out on the lake.
Well, if I do, I shall make love to you. I'm in the mood.
Oh, well, as long as someone does. Rudy. What are you rehearsing first? Rudy?
Hmm?
Oh, Count. Oh, yes. Yes, there are Tyrolean dancers arriving at any moment.
Then we shall hear the music all across the lake. Hansel, can you row fast?
Incredibly. My muscles are stupendous.
Now, I can have a good look at you.
Will I do?
Admirably. I don't know why I still expected bare feet and pigtails.
Then you should have kept me with you.
Weren't you happy at school?
Reasonably. Not at first. My shoes pinched me. The girls did too.
Oh, little beasts.
Oh, I pinched them back, only harder, so they stopped. I had my calendar, of course. I used to tear off the days one by one, but it was too slow. So I saved up and tore off a whole month. Then it got quicker. Oh, Rudy, I was so happy to know you'd bought this place. I thought I really had a home I could come back to. Well, do you like being famous?
Yes, I like it.
I saw Lorelei at Daly Theatre 5 times and Princess in Paris 3 times.
What about the best of them all, Love Song?
No, I read what that was about. It's too sad, a bit soppy. I think Love Soppy, don't you?
Oh, you do? No affairs of the heart?
Of the heart? No. Slight holding hands at end of term dances, but nothing to do with the heart. My heart was somewhere quite different.
Greta. You remember the last morning I was here, where I went to Vienna? You made no promises.
Remember? Of course I do.
Well, I want you to know that all this time, I've taken my promise to you quite seriously.
Come along, you two! The rehearsal started!
Yes, so I was forgetting everything. Come on, come and have a look.
thank you. Oh, it's the heat of the room, all those candles. Do go back in. I'm really quite all right.
Can't sit down and talk to me. I haven't had a minute with you.
You want a minute with me?
I want hours. After all, there was no need to cut me right out of your life. It's been a success, hasn't it?
Oh, yes, of course. We're artists, and we love each other. I'm vile to him sometimes, particularly lately. Charles, I don't like other interests in his life. This little Greta, she's a sweet child and she has character, but...
Yes, she's a sweet child and she has character. In fact, you're good, ordinary, plain jealous.
Yes, I am. I admit it. It's absurd, isn't it? Charles, why doesn't he ask me to marry him? He never has, you know. Well, what are you smiling at?
Oh, it's just that it's such a funny situation. Here am I, longing to ask you the one thing he won't.
Is it because he's not sure of himself? Or is he too sure of me? Or have I been fooling myself all these years?
Have you ever spoken to him about
it? Yes, but he avoids the subject.
Suppose you suddenly found you had to get married.
You mean if I were going to have a child?
Yes. And you are Maria, aren't you?
Yes. But why should having a child make any difference? In fact, it completes the perfect bohemian picture. Oh, Charles, I'm so unhappy.
Maria, you must tell him.
No. Oh, I'm sorry to have blurted it all out like this to you of all people.
Why me of all people? Why shouldn't I be the one person you should tell? After all, I've shared your happiness and I'd share it again.
Even now?
Even now. Tonight.
Oh, don't say it, Charles. I might take you seriously. I don't want people to see me with my face like this. I'll walk you to the landing stage.
Yes. But you'll send me a message. I can't bear to see you unhappy. You'll let me know. Either way.
Either way. It's nice to know you're wanted. For certain.
I can find it for you.
You don't know which one it is.
Well, you said it's called Primrose.
Well, it's all mixed up with a whole lot of other music.
Then let me come with you.
Oh, dear. You're like some awful puppy following me around and biting my ankles.
I can't imagine anything more attractive. I say, stay there a minute.
Why?
You look so nice.
Do I? Oh, Franzl, you are sweet. You say the nicest things just when they're wanted. I could almost...
I don't care for that almost.
Oh, no. You've been kissed.
I've been kissed.
Mm. Help me move the table, would you, please? Right, the table.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
So
I'm relaxed.
I'm fascinated
by one.
Do you realize what it means?
Well, where's the entertainment
bit? Greta's getting the music.
Oh, a couple of musical volunteers, please,
yes,
for piano
yes,
movie.
Yes.
Thank you. Now, all together. Yes?
All right.
Go!
Seems to get heavier every year.
Now, come on, everybody, quickly. Find yourself a space. Greta's going to sing for us. Quickly, everybody, find a seat. Quickly, it's going to begin very soon. So, what's it going to be? A turkey trot?
Oh, no, nothing so modern. It's just one of those little musical comedy numbers that are so popular in England and nowhere else.
What's it called?
Primrose.
generous.
I don't sing like Maria, you know that.
What's he going to do?
Just a verse and a chorus, then I dance. That is, if I can remember the dance. Shall we start, Judy?
Yes, you must tell me if it's in the correct time, because I'm not very good at this new ragtime. Is that all right?
Every other Sunday afternoon, walking till the summer Sunday moon shines above her, you'll love her, Miss Primrose. See her parasol beneath the trees, dainty as a flower, I jump on knees when she walks out with her pink and knees, Miss Primrose. Primrose was a naughty little blossom, and she lived on Primrose Hill, and she always dressed to kill. When she went up west and did her best, Primrose used to come home rather later than the decent hour that pleased her waiter, knowing her daughter ought to be kept a prim, prim rose.
Quite right, we do have to be up very early in the morning. 5 a.m. we're going to be called. All off to bed immediately. Come on, please, everyone. If you've got anything left in the glass, take it with you.
Good night.
Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. See you all bright and early in the morning. Good night.
Woody, I want to talk to you.
What now?
Yes, alone. It's important.
Well, just give me a few minutes. And when you hear me play this, you'll know I'm free.
My ankles again.
Ransel, go to bed, will you, please?
Oh, Lord, I'm always being sent to bed.
Well, it's the right place for children.
Oh, I could give you 10 years.
I wish you would. Go on, go to bed now. I'll sit in the front in the car with you tomorrow.
Oh, Lord, then we're all over the cliff.
Good night.
Good night, Ransel. Good night. Well? How many times has he asked you to marry him?
6 or 7. Afraid I haven't counted.
Oh.
Sounds as though you don't care for the idea.
I haven't really thought about it.
And do better.
Why?
All sorts of reasons. For one, Franzel's one of the nicest people in the world.
Oh, I don't think that's enough.
He's also a dear friend of mine.
That's more encouraging.
And he's very much in love with you.
I'm not very much in love with him.
Oh, well, that makes it a little bit more difficult, and you think you never could be?
I think it's very difficult to get mumps when you've already got mumps.
Mumps are what children get.
Oh, that doesn't make them any less painful.
Greta. I'm years older than you, and I'm not quite the same person you knew.
You mean you're rich now instead of poor, famous instead of unknown?
Oh, those things are unimportant. There are other things.
Shall we take the other things for granted? I don't think I could bear to hear you talk of other things. Oh, poor Rudy. It's difficult for you, isn't it? It mustn't be. I know all about everything, and I'm going to be extremely sensible. I just want you to do one thing for me. I want you to keep your vow, the one you made to stop me from crying. It's all right. You needn't have any fear about my answer. It's just that I want to be able to say, he did ask me. Of course I refused, but he did ask me.
And I thought you hadn't grown up.
Perhaps I haven't. Perhaps this is my last fling of childishness.
Do you really want me to do this?
Yes.
What do you want me to say?
What you would say if you cared.
Oh. If I cared in that way, I'd say, darling Greta, you know everything about me that there is to know. I'm years older than you. I'm dreadfully selfish, incurably ambitious. A supreme egoist, in fact, altogether the last person in the world that you should marry, in spite of all that I'm asking. Will you?
What was that?
What? I didn't hear anything. I'm waiting.
Oh, poor Rudy. Would it be awful for you if I said yes?
Oh, Greta, you wouldn't, would you?
No. That's the first thing you said that makes me know you're just the same. Oh, Rudy, you won't ever laugh at me about this, will you? And you won't ever tell Maria, even when you're married. You're going to be married, aren't you?
Yes. Yes, we are going to be. And do you know, you're the reason we haven't been. My promise to you has always stopped me.
That was important.
First person who ever believed in my music.
I'll always remember that. And when I'm famous, people will say, yes, and you know, she turned down Rudy Kleber. You won't mind if I boast a little, will you? Good night, dear Rudy. I hope I won't disgrace you at the gala tomorrow.
Oh, I don't think that's likely, not. Not after what I've had tonight. Good night. God bless you for being so completely understanding.
Grey hairs. I've never noticed them before.
They weren't there 5 minutes ago. Greta, try now, try and be nice to Franzel, will you please?
I shall be angelic to Franzel. I can afford to be now. Rudy, thank you for giving me the first refusal.
Thank you. announce the next item on the program, the Leap Year Waltz. Rudy has written this specially for Miss Greta Schoen and the Corps de Ballet of the Theatre and de Ville. Miss Greta Schoen and the Leap Year Waltz.
Any sign of Maria yet?
No. Where's she been all day?
I don't know.
Well, she must be here soon. Her song comes immediately after supper.
She hasn't even rehearsed with the orchestra.
Greta, you are wonderful.
Yes, yes, delightful.
Rudy, what's the matter?
It's Maria. We don't know where she is. No one's seen her all day. You were right. She must have overheard last night.
Well, you can explain that in a moment.
If I could find her.
Seem to find my way out of this place.
Yes, madam.
Ah, there you are, Maria. You aren't leaving already? We're all looking forward to your song.
I've had a very busy day.
so busy that you couldn't even come to rehearsal.
Oh, so that's what's upsetting you?
No, not that. I wanted to explain something to you.
About the song?
No, Maria, I must talk to you alone.
I don't think there's anything you can say to me alone that cannot be said in public.
Maria, what's upset you? Oh, you're just overtired.
No, I'm not tired, Cassiel. I have some marvelous news for you. Congratulations, Rudy. I wish you and Greta every happiness. That's my news, Cassiel. Rudy has asked Greta to marry him, and she has accepted.
This is a terrible misunderstanding.
Misunderstanding? But you did ask her to marry him.
In a way, yes.
Luckily, or unluckily, I overheard.
If you'd waited, you would have heard Greta refuse.
Yes, Maria, refuse. Rudy asked me to marry him because he gave me his word that he would, and he kept his word just to please me. And now would you forget all about it? It was nothing, just a childish joke.
Childish joke? I don't think I'm very good at childish jokes.
Maria, I saw you. That's all it was. I nearly went mad last night wondering where you were. And today, no word from you. You could have trusted me. Oh, don't look so tragic. It's all right now, isn't it?
Rudy, when I ran away from you last night, I ran to where I knew I should find comfort, security, and faithfulness. My whole world has crumbled about me. I've loved you so much.
I tried to explain to you the song I wrote. I asked you to wait. That's what it meant.
Don't, Rudy, please. I married Charles Metterling this morning.
What did you say?
I married Charles Metterling this morning.
No.
That's what I meant by faithfulness. Security.
Rudy?
She was my whole world. My music, too. And now that doesn't seem to matter.
You've still got that part of her. Nothing can take that away. And you won't let people pity you, will you?
Pity me? No. Hear them all now. You heard about Rudy and Maria? She's left him. What's he going to do now? Poor Rudy. No. Oh, my God. No, they won't pity me. What's that dirt they're playing?
I didn't write that as a funeral march. I wrote that as a waltz. A happy waltz. Now then. Take your time from me.
13 years ago, do you remember then, Francis? Oscar tells me my friends can't afford to come here anymore.
Dear old Oscar. When is the time he's poured me into a cab at door? People don't know how to get drunk these days.
You should see New York. Rudy, we must take him with us when we go.
I may not be going back to New York.
Rudy, why stay in a place that's so full of ghosts?
I'm
Perhaps that's the point. Ghosts are unhappy people. If I stay, perhaps I can make them less unhappy.
Do take me with you to America. I'm sick of trying to sell cars that won't go to people that can't pay.
In what capacity would you go to America?
As her husband.
Indeed. And what have you to offer me?
6 good suits and a beautiful nature.
Any money?
Certainly not. Don't be vulgar, have you?
Pots.
Thank the Lord for that. If you'd have said you were poor but honest, I'd have cried off. Well, is it on?
I can't say yet. I shall have to ask Rudy, see what he thinks.
Oh, of course.
Oh, go and dance. Go on. Go and dance. You know you're dying to.
Are you sure you don't mind?
Why should I mind? I'm playing one of my waltzes.
Come on, Franca.
It's your usual place, Highness. If I'd known you were coming, I'd have had your favorite roses on the table.
Oh, thank you, Oscar.
May we expect His Excellency?
No, I'm afraid not. Affairs of state, you know.
Can I order for you?
Not yet. I'll call you when I'm ready.
Then let me show you to your table.
My tune, I think.
No, mine. It was written for me.
By whom?
By someone I hoped I'd forgotten.
Someone who hoped he'd forgotten you.
How wrong we both were.
I can't get over it. My first night in Vienna after nearly 13 years, I come into Locker's and you walk.
And I haven't been here for months either. Strange, isn't it?
I'd have known you anywhere.
Oh, well, I wouldn't have known you. So sleek and well-dressed and confident. I feel sure that jacket is not tight and uncomfortable.
No, no. And the whole suit is entirely mine, although it's not yet paid.
That's because you're rich. Only the poor pay cash. I'm right, aren't I? You are rich.
I've been lucky.
And prolific. A Kleber operetta a year. Stick to your money, Rudy. It's important. I never knew how important. I suppose you know we have very little now.
You still have your voice.
Oh, which I seldom use.
Pity.
Yes, silly, isn't it? I've written to you several times.
I never received any letters.
That's because I never posted them. The best letters are seldom posted.
Apparently not.
You never married, did you? Oh, no, of course not, Ali. What about Greta?
She's over there, dancing with Franz. And she's now one of the biggest stars of musical comedy in America. How are things with you?
Oh, I lead a very interesting life. I have my official duties. I'm kept very busy. I don't really have much time to think.
I haven't asked you the most important question of all. Are you happy?
Does that matter? Oh, that song.
Yes, that song.
I know it by heart even now, every word, every note.
My dearest dear, if I could say to you, thank you.
must stop being unhappy. Come back to me. It isn't too late. I'm not talking madness. Your marriage to Charles was based on a misunderstanding between you and I. If he realizes that, he'll let you go. He must let you go.
Oh, but it's over 12 years ago, Rudy. You can't brush aside all those years just like that. I must go on.
Why? Look at me. Can you honestly tell me you've had one moment of happiness since we parted? You see, you can't. For all these years, you've been trying to be someone else. What's the result? You're unhappy and defeated. We both are.
And you?
Utterly.
But I thought...
Don't let's pretend. Maria. Maria. We can still have the future. What's it going to be? Completely happy or utterly wretched? It's for you to decide.
No, Rudy, it's for you to decide.
For me? Then I've decided. Here, now, tonight.
No, not tonight. A week from now, I shall come to you wherever you stay. You shall tell me what I must do.
I don't see what difference a week's going to make.
Oh, perhaps nothing. Perhaps everything. I must go. A week from now.
Where?
I leave that to you.
I know where.
Send me where. Don't come with me. Not tonight.
Maria, stay there just a moment. It's all right. I wanted to be sure I hadn't seen a ghost. Than ever.
Not me. A bit white on top now.
Suits you.
Well, let's have a look at you. You've changed.
Not too much, I hope.
In the right way. You've got a wise look now. I think the little place looks nice.
Yes. Yes. Are you happy here?
Happier than I've ever been in my life. And it's all thanks to you. Whatever made you give it all to me?
I wanted to be sure there was one garden in the world that I could walk into that would always remain unchanged. Oh, I take it all back. What's that? Lights in the trees? An orchestra, Hattie? This is sacrilege.
Well, you know how it is, dear. People like that kind of thing these days. Gotta move with the times, you know.
That's a car. Coming up the hill, it must be her.
Her?
Yes. Maria.
Maria?
Yes, Maria.
But she's...
I know she's a princess now. It's all very difficult, but it's not going to be. You'll see, Hattie. Hattie, you know I love you very much, but you must go away now. I want you to go right away.
Maria!
Yes, Maria.
Oh, I just can't get over it. Do you want coffee, dear?
No, I don't want any coffee. Just go away. Go on, go away.
I'm not late, am I?
No. I was just terrified in case you hadn't received my letter.
Of course I did. And even before I'd opened it, I knew it would be here. You'd choose.
Was it
difficult to get away?
Oh, no, not really. I simply said I was tired and needed the country air. Charles agreed I was looking pale and tired. So I am.
You're looking lovely.
Well, I shouldn't be. I haven't slept too well since that night at Locher's a week ago.
Rhea. Why did you say it would be for me to decide?
It still is.
I don't understand. You're here.
Yes. But I didn't come alone.
No.
No. I do hope you won't think I've taken an unfair advantage of you. You see, I have someone else to consider.
Someone else?
Yes. Now go and say, how do? Nicely.
How do you do, sir?
How do you do?
My name's Carl Metterling.
Mine's Rudy Kleber.
Is that short for Rudolph?
Yes, I believe it is.
I'm sometimes called Carlo. But that's not short for Carl. In fact, it's longer. My mother calls me Carlo. Don't you, Mama?
Herr Kleber writes some of the music you've heard me sing.
I should like to write music. But I think it must be very difficult.
No, not a bit.
Is it anything like typewriting?
Not quite.
Charles gave him a typewriter for Christmas. He drives us mad with it.
How old are you, Carl?
Nearly 13.
See.
Mama, was it true about the coffee creme, or were you making that up?
Oh, no, I wasn't making that up. If you go in there and say that you are Maria Ziegler's son, a very nice old lady will give you by far the best coffee creme you've ever had.
Shall I see you again, sir?
I hope so.
I hope so, too.
I wanted you to see him.
Maria does Charles now?
Yes, he knew from the first.
He must love you very much.
He does.
And you?
I'm grateful.
Is that enough, Maria? Why didn't you tell me?
I tried to that night.
Right.
Rudy, are you still asking me to go away with you? It would mean a clean break.
The boy, too.
Charles loves him as if he were his own son. The world, too, takes it for granted that he is. They're devoted to each other. It's a happy little world for him. I don't think we can break that little world of his to pieces.
Maria. Is it any joy to you to know that he is mine?
Infinite joy.
Talk to him of me sometimes. Blame some of my music, perhaps. Then if we ever meet, we shan't quite be strangers. No, Maria, there's so little time and there are so many things I have to say, but I'm going to tell you something that I want you to remember for always. I love you. And only you. You have always been the color and the magic in my life, and nothing could ever take that away. We are going to see great changes, I know. I feel it. There is so much unrest and unhappiness in the world. We shall almost forget to smile. and make music, but we shan't quite forget. And one day we'll wake, as if from an evil dream, and forget to hate. And the world will smile again, and the sweetness of music and friendship will once more be important. Keep me in your heart, as I will keep you in mine. I shan't even be unhappy now that I know we have something we can share.
Mama!
I'm here, Carl.
Look, Mama, she gave me all these lovely cakes. Can I take them back to school? She said it would be all right.
Did you thank her properly?
Yes. I actually kissed her, but she didn't mind. Will you be coming back with us to Vienna, sir?
No, I'm afraid I shan't be going back to Vienna.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yes, I'm sorry too, Carlo. Oh, forgive me, I should say Carl.
Oh, no, please. Carlo, it's much more friendly.
Yes, it's much more friendly.
Now say goodbye to Herr Kleber, then go and sit in the car and wait for me.
Goodbye, sir.
Goodbye, Carlo. I will always remember our meeting.
I hope I did right in bringing him to you.
Yes.
We won't say goodbye, will we? I don't think I could. But do something for me. Go and sit at the piano where I first saw you. Long, long before you saw me. And play for me.
Helped a great number of people to escape. People who
people
are known
who only wish to leave a country which clearly has no further use for them.
Allow me to continue. My superiors are concerned at the way in which you have abused your personal wealth, bribed our officials, and made a mockery of our administration. But provided you undertake to stop these subversive activities at once, we shall remove the ban on your music.
Well, it's most generous of you. What you mean is you've discovered that my music is too popular, too national in spirit to be suppressed. And your superiors, if there are any grades of superiority in your organization.
Being cynical will not help you.
Forgive me being cynical. I intended to be insulting. You can tell your superiors that I shall go on doing just as I'm doing now. Do you really think this ban on my music here in our country has killed it for the world outside? It's where my music is. And my music is my wealth. And you can't touch it. It's there for anybody to use. To remind them there was once a place called Vienna where the only crime was to be unhappy.
Be careful, Herr Kleber. You have a simple choice, but be warned. If you are arrested again, you will not be released quite so quickly.
Princess Metterling, Herr Kleber.
Maria.
Rudy. Are you all right? I came as soon as I heard they'd let you go. What have they done?
Oh, nothing. They just threatened me, tried to stop me helping people escape.
Charles did everything he could to get you released. He's promised to do what he can in the future.
Thank you, Maria.
But I'm not sure how much longer his influence will last. Those bullies are getting stronger every day. They're turning our whole world upside down.
All the more reason to go on resisting them. Oh, they don't frighten me. I didn't mind. Even when they locked me up, my thoughts were far away. Somewhere with you. Back over the years. The dancing years.
They'll come again. For both of us.
Maria, tell me, our son Carlo, does he think as they do?
No, he thinks as we do.
Thank God. Now I shall never feel that my life has been completely wasted.
Wasted? How could it be wasted? You know what they'll say of you? He made the whole world dance.
Thank you. Marilyn Hill Smith is a member of the English National Opera.